So, similarly, for example, when you are, say, dogs are barking outside, okay, or you see something, somebody knocks your door, okay, or the bell, doorbell rings. Now, doorbell rings, a story starts, okay. So, for example, in a radio play, I just give you an example that first a doorbell rings, and that is a sound. After that, the door opens, and that is also a sound. So the opening of door is a sound. The doorbell is a sound. Then somebody walks in. So let us say the shoes, you have some sound of the shoes. And then somebody, that the person gets into the room and pulls a chair. So the ch sound of the pulling of the chair will be there. So you see now how it had developed from doorbell to the opening of the door and shutting of the door, then using it, shutting it from inside, and then pulling of the chair, that sound, and then somebody sits and then speak something. Now this is human sound. So you see, the story here started, and everything is sound. Now, how do you tell that this is a young man, or this the somebody who has come inside is a is an old man, or is a, I mean, who is he? Okay, so now you have to think of some sounds that will give the listener idea that this man is. Okay, now one point is that somebody speaks. So from this speech, one can make out, say, when a child speaks, or a teenager speaks, an adult speaks, or a middle-aged person speaks, or an elderly person speaks, or a very old person speaks, the voice tells some idea of the age. Okay, but sometimes this can be deceptive. So you can also think of some other ways. Okay, other ways have to be thought. So what I'm telling you is the that it's not something new for you. And before you do it, you can listen to one radio play. I will give you a link of one radio play, and that you can listen. Now you'll find out how the sound tells the story. Okay. This is, this is what I wanted to tell in the first phase of today's interaction, that you are going to tell the story. You must know what the plot and the story is. The story you are telling is through sound that you understand. And I'll give you one example which you can listen to. And now, of course, you have books, and you have to study how the story, how the plot opens, and how the story is told, event after event. Okay, what is the visualization? Now we know that this play Tara, you see, there are different locations. What is the location that Dan, who is telling the story, is the person who was Tara's brother. And after the tragedy that she died, and a lot of things happened, he came to know later that right from the beginning, when the operation took place of the conjoined twin, he was favored. And this favoring to Tara actually led to a lot of problems in her life. Now, he has this guilt inside his. So in England, Dan, with no personal history there, because it's England now, and he he is Dan there. Now Dan is recreating memory. So the play actually happens as a memory. So it's very challenging for radio people to create memory and tell that story by means of memory. So we have to really think. Now on stage, what we can do, for example, we have a stage and we have three areas. One is top, one is bottom, and another is middle. So in the middle area, we create memory, the history, the past. That is the flashback. Okay. In one area, we create the present, where Dan is sitting and telling the story. And on one area, you can create another set. Okay. For example, in this play, a doctor is sitting there constantly watching the story being told. So three levels are there. Now, in physical space, here you have light, for example. So you can use three different kinds of lights for these three different kinds of sets. So the set that tells the memory or the past, you can have a light which shows more, which is not depicting the present. So let us say if it is a kind of black and white space. In some movies, they use black and white to show past. And the present is real. So real. Okay. Now, for us in radio play, to create these different areas, okay, will be challenging. But it's not as challenging as to go to moon. Okay. So here we would require three kinds of sounds or atmospheres which can create three sounds, different kind of sounds tracks, soundtracks or background scores that can create three different atmospheres, so that in the play we know that right now it is memory that is coming from, or right now this is the present from where the narrator is speaking or the writer is speaking, or who are speaking from which spaces. So now when you have the play, think, read this and see how it is developing, and everywhere take clues. If the writer is giving clues in the text, some sounds or something, you can use it. If the writer is giving some clues for directing it for the stage, then you rethink how to turn them into sound or radio. Now you see, let us go to the textual part.
Asserted by his sheer godlike presence on the stage level, running along the cyclorama and in an L-shaped downstage right is the gully outside the Patel's house, which can be suggested by cross lighting. The play starts without any music. A spot picks up Dan at his writing table. He is typing furiously. He stops and removes the sheet from his typewriter. He looks up and speaks to the audience.
Okay.
Dan.
So, right. Dan starts speaking there. But before that, the set has been described. So, this is for the visual, for the stage. But we have to visualize it from the point of view of radio play. Okay, and this talks about a multiple set. Multiple set, that is, the stage is not at one time showing one set, but at one time simultaneously the stage is showing three different areas. We have here this description. Now we have to rethink about this description and put it in our context. Okay, our context is not a stage play. Our context is a radio. B, Darasinglina.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Can you guess? Think about how to visualize it. How to really?
We can by imagining a room where there is a bed, a small bed.
We have a. Please carry on.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah. We could think about it like a small bed with a small writing table and a typewriter and a sheet of paper.
Okay. So that's typewriter has a noise.
Yes, sir.
Because sound can be created. Okay.
Yes.
So sir. Typewriter sound for Dan will be okay.
Yeah.
So so if we give typewriter sound to Dan, so we can always in this dialogue understand that it is Dan who is speaking while yes, typing. Sir. But what about the second area? I mean, where he is talking about his memory, and then out of memory will come the characters, the past, Tara and others. I mean, how to really, for example, if you begin our storyboard right from Dan, okay, Dan speaks, okay. Now, what does Dan speak? Do you have the book with you?
Yes.
Okay. Can you read out that dialogue? Dan.
Dan. In poetry, even the most turbulent emotions can be recollected when one is half asleep. But in drama, even tranquility has to be recalled with emotions, like touching a bare live wire. Try distancing yourself from the experience and writing about it. A mere description will be hopelessly inadequate. And for me, I have to relive that charge over and over again. Excuse me while I recharge myself. Till there. I have my memories, locking myself in a bedsitter in a seedy suburb of London. Thousands of miles from home hadn't put enough distance between us. My battery charger helped on some occasions, but now I want them to come back. Domesticate my memories in my mind and spit out the results to the world in anger. My progress so far, I must admit, has been zero. But I persist with the comforting thought that things can't get any worse. I keep staring at my typewriter every day, wondering how best to turn my anguish into drama. All I find every day without fail is one typewritten sheet with the title of the play, my name and address, and the date. Nothing changes except the date.
Okay.
Okay.
Right.
Drama in two plays by Chandan Patil. Copyright Chandan Patil, 93 Fishponds Road, Tooting, London, SW177LJ. Today I made some progress. I even typed my phone number. Not to say that I don't have anything to show to the world yet. I do, for instance, these short stories of the British Raj. Still hounding publishers. The publishers here ignore them because none of them deal with sati, dowry, deaths of child marriage, or child marriages. All subjects guaranteed to raise the interest of the average Western intellectual. And back home, of course, Indo-Anglian literature isn't worth toilet paper. But that's all done with. Tonight, I dropped everything I desperately wanted to be in my years in England. The handicapped intellectual's mask, the desperate immigrant, the mysterious brown with the phony accent, the last being the hardest to drop having spent 2 whole years in acquiring it. And what remains is what I intend making capital of. My freakishness. I am a freak. Now, a freak doesn't have to look very far for inspiration. But what is hard is to let go. Allow the memories to flood in. To tell you the truth, I had even forgotten I had a twin sister. Until I thought of her as subject matter for my next literary attempt. Or maybe I didn't forget her. She was lying deep inside, out of reach. Yeah.
Okay. So what we notice here, this is our first exposure to this speech. Therefore, it may not have made much sense to you. But now we have to rethink about it. That one thing is that Dan is a writer, and no one else, and Dan is actually I mean the person who has suffered, okay, and Tara's he's Tara's brother. Now he has to tell this story. Now we can imagine that nobody is going to listen to his story if he tells this story in India to Indians and in his own mother tongue. The mother tongue may be Hindi or maybe Punjabi or maybe Gujarati. Why people won't listen to him? The reason is that Indians will not like to listen to such a story that talks about what has been prohibited to talk about. So this is something, you know, this is a prohibited area. And say how his sister died, how they were born as conjoined twins, the separation by surgery.
He says that he hasn't written the play, but he has written some random stories of British Raj. But
Please carry on.
But people in India won't accept those stories because they do not like to hear about all the English culture. And people in England won't accept that because it doesn't focus on the matters such like dowry or child marriage or deaths.
No, we'll come to that. We'll come to that. There are many, you know, annotations, footnotes to these references. And we must understand this entire thing, and I'll also annotate those areas which we have taken up. So you see, this is, let us say, this is very clear. I mean, will Indian society listen to his story? I mean, let us first begin here. I mean, this is a conjoined twin. And because of patriarchal norms, the favors were made for the male, not for the female. And then things, you know, took shape. The self or the gender was created, a male gender and a female gender. And you see, now, if he tells this story, I mean, sister died, can he really tell this story to someone in India? What is your opinion? Would somebody like to speak about it? You can just send a message. I will unmute for you to talk. Or is it possible for you to talk? I mean, would somebody add to this that is our society open enough to listen to this kind of personal story?
So actually, it won't be appreciated, but there would be some people in society, like there are some different people who would listen to it, but it would not be appreciated.
Would not be appreciated. So it means that...
But nowadays with broadened mentality, I guess it would be appreciated.
Actually, today it would be, because today there is much more empowerment to women. But if we're talking about the play or the days back in that day, then back in that time, it won't be appreciated.
That time. No, time is not very,
the play is written in 90s, I think.
Okay. And do we have lot of news in media on Dori death and girl child discrimination? Then recently, the government has to ban the female feticide. Otherwise, there was a huge crisis. Middle class families started killing their girls in the fetus. And do you think that, people, when they kill a girl child in the fetus, they talk about it in the open?